Still going strong, 3 hours in.
The market conditions right now, both in the United States and in Japan, are the worst that I've ever seen in my lifetime. Point Marina, Port Harbor Marine, for the Casco Bay Bluefin Bonanza Kids Day. You ought to come down and check this stuff out. We've got our friends from Bass Pro Shops, Cabela's. They're going to be giving some fishing lessons down on the dock. And we've got Walt Golette from the Gulf of Maine Research Institute, who's just finished up a demonstration on bluefin tuna.
So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to look for the brain.
Oh.
Okay. We're going to look for the brain.
We're back live again from the Casco Bay Bluefin Bonanza. We've got a ton of kids down here fishing on the docks. They're fishing for crabs and pollock and mackerel. And a special last minute feature. If anybody wants to come down right now and get a chance to go on a real authentic tuna boat, come on down, kids. Come check this out. This guy is one of the top fishermen in the fleet. And he's tied his boat up here just so that the kids can go on a real live, just like you see on Wicked Tuna. In fact, these guys are actually better fishermen than the guys on Wicked Tuna. They are so good that they won't even let them on the show. This is Kurt. Say hi, Kurt.
Hey, Bob. How we doing?
We're going to get some of these.
So, once again, our friends from Cabela's and Bass Pro, fishing lessons. You get a free hat. You get a free bucket. You might just even get a fishing rod if you come down. We're going to be here for about another hour doing this before we start to gear up for our live auction, raffle, lobster dinner. And Walt's still here cutting up tuna heads. So if you want to check that out. Come on down. But while I've got your attention, let's go take a look at some of the items that will be in our auction and raffle this evening. We've got balls. We got some great stuff here. We've got this, I don't know what that is, but looks like it belongs in the closet. We've got some clothes, some dude wipes. Yeah, some of this fancy beer for you folks that don't like regular beer. Some packages from our sponsors at Milton Cat. How about some coffee from Starbucks? We've got beef jerky. We've got candy. Extra tough boots. If they don't. Toadfish Outfitters. These cups are really cool. They'll stick anywhere. And these two. Pen. Yep, William Penn gave us that. How about coasters in a glass? This boat tool. This is a handy item here. If you have a boat and you need a tool, here's a paper bag. This is Sean. Sean's. Say hi, Sean.
Hi.
Helen. Say hi. Hi to the folks.
Hello.
Cups, glasses. Look at these glasses. Tuna tail etched right in there. Isn't that cool? Look. Shirts.
Jacket.
Hey, Grundon's. Nice. Compliments of Grundon's and Vessel Services.
And two look at that.
Shirts.
And two shirts. All you need to stripe a fish package from Bass Pro Shops. Cabela's right there. It's even got one of these doohickeys. And some of those. Now we're getting to the good stuff. Two folding chairs. A pair of binoculars. A paper bag. Filet mat. How about 1 dozen live lobsters from our friends at Free Range Fish and Lobster. That's going to go out for a live auction. We've got a fish fryer double basket set with oil. This custom made end table dresser, whatever you call it, made by the students at Central Maine Community College, which is one of the colleges that we sponsor with our scholarships. And they also made this. Check this Adirondack chair out. And it's even engraved. Yeah, man. A captain's bucket. You, too, can be a real tuna captain, or at least pretend that you are, with this bucket. Everything that the captains get, you'll get. But you're going to have to pay for it. And, folks, don't tell anyone, but look at this. Yeah, buddy. When they come to the front door, you'll be ready with this. How about a weekend stay at Lake Parlin Lodge and Cabins? Or for all those fish that you catch, a vac sealer. Need gaffs? We got gaffs. We got gaffs, we got harpoons. These are from our friends at Endgame Tuna Gear. And for our enemies, we got some 9mm. Power washer so you can wash the boat down when you're done fishing after you gaff that big tuna. Regulation handmade American flag cornhole boards from Brian Jones, our head waymaster. $250 in marine diesel from Vessel Services and Dennis K. Burke. Thank you very much. 7 cubic yards of any product manufactured by our sponsors at Gorham Sand and Gravel. If you're doing some work around the yard, the house, the driveway, you want get that. Our good friends at LT Marine, we have a couple harpoons here. We've got an 8-foot and a 10-foot two-piece cockpit harpoon, professional grade.
Hello!
We've got the famous LT Marine swim hook. I've got one of these, and this thing is awesome. You gotta get that. A release hook, which is, now that we can't fish, thank you, Noah. Thanks very much for that. You can go out and catch and release. Everyone needs swivel rod holes. You cannot possibly have enough. I've got 6 and it's not enough. I might bid on these myself. So come on down. We still get an hour of kids' activities, and then social hour begins at 4 p.m. Hope to see you then. Bring lots of money. Bye for now.
Yeah.
worried I was going to see some white cloud in this fish, because you can see he's had some sort of either interaction or an attack or something. It's a deformed fin. Often we'll see white cloud when there's stuff like that, but I don't see any. Looks nice and red. Not a lot of fat, but a little bit. Really hope to see the meat turning white here in the belly side minor lobe to indicate fat, but it does have a little bit.
Still going strong, 3 hours in.
Hey boys, how was the fight? No.
The market conditions right now, both in the United States and in Japan, are the worst that I've ever seen in my life. The market in Japan last Friday was the worst I've ever seen.
So the restaurant business is very off in Japan.
Bailey and Bella, 646, their third fish. Welcome!
Anticipated restricted fishing days, an unexpected category closure, then restricted fishing days, and weather. It's amazing that we were even able to pull this thing off, but we did it. And credit to all you guys for hanging in there with us, for being so supportive. You know, a lot of schedule changes. It was very difficult for us, and I'm sure it was difficult for all you people. You have schedules, you have vacation time, you have to get help. I did not hear one single negative word from anyone in the fleet about all the shuffling and stuff that we had to do. So I thank you very much for that, because you guys made it so much easier for us. And as you can imagine, it was quite a struggle. Without further ado, we're going to hand out some awards tonight. For the bold and the brave that went out there and fished in this weather. But before I do, a little review. In 2020, last year we had 44 boats registered. 24 boats landed fish. 24 total, is that right?
24 fish were landed by 22 boats.
Thank you. For a total of 10,700 pounds, average weight of 445. This year, 10 boats landed 15 fish for a total of 8,136 pounds, and the average weight was 542.
So that's pretty good.
Yeah, so that's almost 100 pounds heavier average for the weight of the fish. You guys caught some slammers. Some really nice fish. That's awesome. In fifth place, with a 102.5-inch, 632-pound tuna was Captain Kurt Christensen and Molly Jane. Woo! You gotta come up, Kurt.
Hey. I was tail rope guy.
Ready?
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Nice job, guys.
Shoot, Kurt.
Fourth place with a 107-inch, 646-pound bluefin tuna. Captain Keith Jordan and the Bailey and Bella.
You guys are all great.
When we come in, you guys come into the docks, you're very patient. This crew may have the greatest fan club out there.
We're saying it's a party tent. I can't give them shit. It's blowing 35 and they still got their party tent on. It should be great.
Mitch, that tent died today. Oh, it died today.
We're going to get a new one.
In third place,
where you look, there's another asshole.
With a 104-inch, 698-pound bluefin. And this guy really is a nut. Mitch Napolitano.
Thank you, guys. Bob, I appreciate it.
And speaking of second place, in second place with a 103.5-inch bluefin that weighed 700 pounds even, Captain Keith Jordan and the crew from Bailey and Bella.
Oh, we made it!
The winner, first place, and the winner of the 2021 Casco Bay Bluefin Bonanza and the Casco Cup, Captain's Pete Speeches, Backstabber, the 105, 719-pound tuna.
You're going to be downgraded to the room you stay in West Palm if you don't get a good picture.
All right. That's a tough act to follow, but this year we added one new prize category, which is most cumulative weight. And the winner brought in a combined weight of 1928, the year after I was born. A combination of three fish over 3 days. I believe the only boat to land at three fish, right?
I think so.
Yep. Wait in three fish. Wait in three fish.
Yeah, that's all that matters.
Bailey and Bella.
Here we go, Pete.
Here we
go, guys.
Once again.
Eric. Just to remind everybody, it's not just about fishing.
Holy shit's getting deep.
There's a reason that we do this. There's a reason we had the auction, the raffle, the dinner. There's a reason we have the registration fees and all this. Some of it goes back to the captains, but most of it goes back to the community. We're really trying to build a better, stronger community, and we do that by providing scholarships. This year we will again provide 14 scholarships, so that'll be two $1,000 scholarships to students from each of the seven main community colleges. We will again be providing support for at least one intern, if not more, through the University of Maine, working at the Gulf of Maine Research Institute, like this young lady right here, who was our recipient last year. And we're going to step up our contribution to the Gulf of Maine Research Institute and Walt's Pelagic Lab and all the important tuna stuff that they do that goes on to ICAT and allows us to continue to catch fish and hopefully catch more fish in the future, because you guys all saw it. There's a ton of fish out there, and we need to get that message up to the scientists and the managers who make decisions in this fishery. So once again, thank you everybody, and we'll see you next year.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.